Welcome back for hour two of this week, this week's A Song and Tara. And we are about to enter all manner of mayhem and carnage in the nightclub called The Church as soon as somebody fixes the echo.
What echo? No,
I refuse to fix the echo.
Oh.
Let's see. I'll probably just do as I usually do and between when I'm talking, because the echo will just keep rising and I can't do anything to stop it.
That sounds like a good idea. Okay, well, we we shall commence then. The last thing that happened was that some gifts were used, and
yes, and I had actually one more I would like to use, if possible.
Well, that will have to be next round. Because cool. As you have used your gifts, you realize that from up under the roof and the rafters, darkness descends on all of you.
I said before that I would be sneaking, stealthing also. Would that have to wait then? Or
yeah.
Could I do that at the same time?
You didn't say that you were splitting your dice pools, so no.
I don't think we knew we were in combat.
We definitely did not know that.
And that's why you can't. It happens. Okay, let me explain. You were heard. They have a surprise action. This is what is happening.
Cool.
I imagine Taryn looking at her phone and Krinos. Oh, above, and then just, oh fuck.
Yeah. So you have a pitch black tar-like darkness descending on all of you, and it's descending rapidly.
Mm-hmm.
So before the round is over, you are all standing in a kind of darkness that you quite literally cannot see in. You can hear, you can smell all these things. Yes, but you cannot actually see a thing.
This pisses Finna off. It reminds her of Molly.
It, what?
Yeah, it reminds her of Molly Malone.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Should we then establish initiative? Or?
Yes, you should.
So that is, as Chris said earlier, 1d10 plus dexterity and witch, yes?
Yes.
Yeah, all the witches. So I have the issue where I can't actually see what my different forms give me. It just says 000.
If you are in Hispo, you'll have +2 dexterity.
And if I am in Krinos, because I cannot
+1.
Check my phone in Hispo.
Yes, just ask and I'll tell you. It's +1 dexterity in Krinos.
All right, but at least I get more strength out of it.
+4. And +3.
Could we maybe have a box with a colored background rather than the map? Because that's going to be hard to read anything on.
We believe in you, Joan. You can do it.
Shut up, Rasmus.
I refuse.
Aww. Okay.
I am here to support my friend in making a colored box.
Whoa.
Yay, it's
color. I guess I got what I was asking for.
Yeah, we are not in doubt that this is it. Not only we can't see the storyteller writing on it because it's the same color. How is it you add text? This is so long ago now. Oh,
you go to the... You go to the eye?
Yeah, I found it.
Changing the text size before you type is...
Did I? Get your fat ass off me.
Sorry.
Is he sitting on you?
What was the general size we established long, long, long ago?
Did we establish
size 40?
A general size?
I think we established one size that was like, okay, let's use this normally.
Dev 26, that's a pretty decent size.
Oh, I'm at size 40.
Me too.
I go down to Asriel's size. just because.
Yeah, 26 then. Also, I think the black ones should turn white.
Ow!
So it's easier to read on the colored background.
Go away. I like black.
Yeah, but it's kind of hard to read.
Then I'll go gray, because my fur. I'm different, shut up.
Clearly.
Okay.
Sorry. Okay. Oh, and we should probably...
Why did I write
put if we use rage as well?
Yeah, I'm not using rage because I don't know where they are.
Plus, of course, if you're using gifts, you can't use rage.
Hmm.
No, that's only if you spend gnosis.
That's true, yeah. So next turn, when I activate, if I get the chance to activate the gift Unified Force, I will not be able to use rage that turn because I haven't had a chance to, because it's a surprise round. I'm going to use rage this turn.
So how is it we decide who's first of me and Taliesin?
Who has the higher?
We both have plus 8. No, wait, did you have... you have plus 7, so I have plus 8, so me. Go me. Me.
You win.
We know.
Can't hear you.
We're going to declare in reverse order as always. So, Fenna, first. What do you want to do?
Well, I am moving into hiding.
Yep.
As in, I'm moving, trying to, get...
Sure.
I don't know if I'm... Well, actually, Fenna doesn't know whether or not she's spotted yet, so...
Exactly.
What she does is that she is going to move upwards while trying not to be seen.
Yep. And Azrael is going to use another gift.
Stupid Azrael, fall down and die.
Be nice to him. He has enough on his back with those wings.
Taryn, what are you going to do?
I can't see shit.
Nope.
Oh yeah, she doesn't know that much. She can't see shit.
Yeah.
She's,
but
she's
all going... I know is he's above somewhere if he hasn't jumped down. So I'm gonna climb up to him and see if I can push the birdie down from its stick.
Right. Now I have to ask, is it even possible for Finna to try to move like that when she can't see? That seems unlikely.
That is a good point, but you can smell your way to a place to hide. So, in lupus, you would still be able to do so.
Okay, then I change from trying to move stealthily to trying to find somewhere to
hide. Yeah. And that's fine. Taliesin, what do you do? Hello?
Hello, yes?
Ah, there you are. What do you do?
Yeah, I'm here. I'm just thinking. I'm going to, I suspect I'm going to use the opportunity to... Well, not dodge, because I can't work. I could dodge, but I'm not dodging an attack, am I?
You can declare that your intention is to avoid any incoming attack.
That will be the case then. Yep, I think that will be my intention then.
Okay. And Deadeye?
Well, for the first round, Deadeye will activate his gift Silence, which makes every sound he makes not exist.
Okay, so he goes total stealth. Except
he goes stealth, total stealth.
Except stealth has nothing to do with sound, but you know what I mean.
Well, I mean, it's a part of being not spotted.
True.
And he doesn't smell, so there's really only sight left, unless you can feel him. Also,
well,
what kind of action is it to revert to breed form? Is that something I can do all while doing this?
You can always revert to breed form.
Then he will also do that for the enhanced smell. Smelling abilities.
Yes. Good.
Yeah, Taryn pointedly didn't put back her scent of running water. She's still smelling of cooch.
Yeah. Okay, well, Dead Eye, you first.
With the rage rounds?
No. So that's right. There's no roll for you, really.
Yeah. Okay. I do it. Okay. That was my turn.
There's no role involved in actually using that gift, is what I mean. So yeah.
Yes, okay. Exactly.
Tally.
We are completely.
You are
misunderstanding.
Yes, Tally. You are basically saving your ability to act until, well, if you should get attacked.
Yes, he's relying on his smell and hearing to anticipate incoming attacks and dodge them.
Mm-hmm. And then it's Taryn's turn.
Yeah, she is going for the wall to climb.
But what about her fear of heights?
I need to see... Well, yeah, there is that. She's got a fear of heights, doesn't she?
She does. And for her to go against what she actually thinks, she'll mm-hmm. have to do a will save. Now, what is her willpower? Her willpower is... Ooh, one more than it usually is. Go, Taryn! Did that do anything? Yeah, it did.
Yep.
Yeah, she's not happy, but she is determined. Birdie's gonna die.
Yeah. Okay, you climb. And let me see that is a dex and athletics.
Cool. She still needs to go into boot camp, though. Don't fail it. I said, don't fail it.
Actually, that's a botch.
Yeah, she can't see shit in there. So, yep.
Do you want to use fate?
Sure, why not?
Yeah, we can't have that's a good. Fallen
brigand. Your fate is actually helping you today for a change.
It really wants us to kill the bird.
Clearly. This is perhaps part of what you were fated to do. Anyway, you get...
She's probably looking upwards while she's climbing because mm-hmm. don't look down.
That takes you from a one botch to a one success.
Mm-hmm.
So you start climbing. It'll take you... around to get up to the landing. I don't know, do you remember what the what it looked like when I showed you the pictures?
Yep.
Good.
I'm fully aware.
Yep. So there's a landing on over the main room downstairs
there, yeah.
And that's where you're heading up, and that'll take you around to get up there. Okay.
Yep.
And
it's fine.
Then it is Azrael, who uses another gift. And as he does so, you hear this surreal voice mocking you. It echoes off all the walls. You're actually not quite sure where it comes from. Where it says he chuckles and says, "I see all of you," and then here we go. Out of the darkness comes a something very, very, very unpleasant. Let me see who it goes for. And you have... All right, it goes for Tally, so you have a chance to dodge, fortunate for you.
So okay. The darkness forms into this thing?
No,
or...
actually, sorry. It specifically says it is impossible to dodge this. Sorry.
Oh, great.
But it can be resisted.
Resisted? How does one resist it?
I shall tell you. Stamina difficulty 8.
Just stamina?
Yes.
If so, 1d plus 3.
Remember, you have plus 3 if you're in Krenas.
That's true. So, is it plus 3 stamina when I'm in Krenas? I thought it was just plus 2.
It's plus 3 as Krenas. It's also plus 3 as Hispo, but you get more strength in Krenas.
Okay. What? What's that? That's not right.
No, that is definitely not
you
right.
You did it the D&D way.
Mm.
My apologies. I need to roll
6d10, not 1d10 plus 6, yes.
Please disregard the previous roll, storyteller. That was a complete fluff on my part.
Yes, no problem.
It's
oh,
fake.
For fuck's sake.
All right.
I think you should use fake.
I really wanted to ask if you could at least keep the 7 you had rolled. But then you rolled before I could say anything.
Oh. Go ahead and roll. Do you want to roll fate?
I would really suggest it.
Okay, so it's, let me just check how many fate points I have.
You can always roll 2 because that's the highest fate we have in our pack.
Okay.
Unless you want there. To do something oh. that. Yeah! Yay! So,
that's one success.
Do one success.
Do you. What's it called? Do you want to spend the willpower point to get an extra success, or do you stick with the 1?
I have some willpower to spare. I'll spend an extra point.
Okay.
When well, she asks like that, it's always good to say, yep.
Okay. In that case, you take 4 health levels of aggravated damage as a ball of balefire slams into you. Because you get a success, you do in fact not mutate.
How are you?
Now, where do I... here we are.
I already dislike that power.
Me too. We should really find him.
4 health levels.
Hopefully
so
it takes a lot of his resources.
Well, now I go back to my question. Did the darkness turn into this ball? Or is this still darkness so we can't actually see it?
You can't see it. You hear something roiling and hissing, and you feel those of you that it passes by, which would be Fenna and Taryn, you feel momentarily extremely nauseous, like you're just on the verge of throwing up. It passes very, very swiftly, but it's there, and you can feel heat. But you can't see a damn thing, and it's Tally doesn't actually realize that he is under attack until this thing smashes into him, and it is the most painful thing you have ever felt. What balefire is, quite literally, is a nuclear flame.
We've tasted it before.
Yeah.
But did it come from above and down?
Yes, it did.
Good. Then I head in the direction it came from, because now he just unknowingly gave me a direction to climb in.
True.
Need to heal.
Yeah. Then, didn't you have grandmother's touch?
No, I don't have grandmother's touch. That's a level 2 gift.
Yeah.
I only have mother's touch.
Yeah. Well, come over here. Come over here, Mom. Follow the scent. You can still smell Taryn.
All right, well, that takes care of that. Then it's Fenna's turn.
Go, Fenna!
Well, all I can do is, well, if I'm trying to hide, it would be wits plus stealth, right?
Yes.
Yes, and you're going to set the difficulty sufficiently high due to not being able to see where I'm actually going and finding a place to hide.
Yes, but on the other hand, as I said, you do have your sense of smell. So,
yes, I do. I'm not going into Lupus, though, because I have my gun stuff to carry, so I'm staying in Glabro.
Yep.
But I still have the regular minus 2 too.
Exactly, you still have acute sense of smell, so...
Oh, don't budge it. It would be so sad to see you trying to hide under a light.
Yes.
Maybe just 1.
No, it's 2 successes. And this means that you do in fact find a place to hide. You find the upstairs toilet. It's easy to smell your way in there. However, the thing is that you realize when you pop in there, you blink your eyes because there is no darkness in there.
Cool.
Oh, nice.
So if I peek out of there, can I then see what's going on? Or?
No. I
see darkness.
You see darkness. You see tendrils of it sort of snaking into the bathroom now that the door is open, but it doesn't actually come in.
sounds awfully enemy.
On the upside, there wasn't any darkness in there, so you don't plump your foot into the toilet.
Just how high do you think my steps are?
And I actually have to say, I am being a very bad storyteller because I've forgotten something. But it doesn't really, it's actually all right because I managed to roll snake eyes because obviously...
As long as you're forgetting things in our favor, it's okay.
What do you roll snake eyes on?
I forgot one.
Oh yeah! Mr. Goodface.
What?
Oh, Leo, you can do it!
Mister, they won't ever hit me.
Yes, Lou is there after all, and he hadn't rolled initiative.
Whoops.
So, but
he was so flabbergasted by the darkness.
It was blocking out his favorite stars.
What he does is he in the darkness you can hear the telltale sound of someone changing into greenos. What? Can you hear me? Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Can you hear me now? Still nothing? Okay, here's the thing, guys. We're going to have to end the call here and try again.
Oh, shit.
Oh, can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you now.
I finally managed to get through.
Okay, suddenly that was extremely strange. Let's hope that doesn't happen again. Because that was a long, uncomfortable silence. Is everybody else here?
Can Christopher hear us? He was having issues coming back in. To me, it just said connecting as if it couldn't.
Me
so
too.
I left again and came in, and then suddenly it said that I were connected, but I couldn't hear anything, and then suddenly all sound came at once.
It's probably just a Discord hiccup.
Probably.
Anyway,
Chris, are you there?
I am.
Good.
Oh, good.
So we can hear everyone.
That was weird.
Can we?
Yes.
Caleb, you too?
Wee.
Good.
Wee. Well, go to the toilet.
As I was about to say,
I am already in there.
As I was about to say, I forgot to roll for Lou, and now I have. And what you hear him spending his round on is changing into Krenos.
Okay. Makes sense.
Yes.
So we have to roll again, I guess.
Indeed. Well, no, you don't.
No, we have the rage rounds.
There are rage actions, yes.
All right.
And we do that in reverse order again. So, Tally, what do you want to do with your rage action?
Not sure what I can do with it, really. There's nothing to attack, as far as I'm aware.
Nope.
And I've not got any means of healing aggravated damage, so...
True.
You do, but it's playing Spider Wolf. Not that you can see it, but it is.
My immediate instinct, I think, is to use the action to... it's actually to back off to take cover somewhere.
Yes. Behind the bar or something.
Yes. If I even remember where the bar is, roughly...
The middle.
Yes, the bar is a big round thing in the middle, so... You know.
And there's a large, tall bar... thing with a lot of flasks and stuff on it in the middle of the bar.
Yes, but bearing in mind I can't see it, so I'm going to have to...
No, but
it's not...
Maybe
you can It is not difficult to find. You saw it when you came in. You have an idea of where it is.
Maybe if I stick my head in one of the defunct fridges, the darkness won't be in there. Who knows? But yeah, I go for the bar.
Well, you find it, and you get behind it, and that's your rage action. Deadeye?
Yes, so... Deadeye can't fly.
Nope.
No. But
on
could
the
be cool
other
if
hand,
he
is actually not a stupid wolf. So I think he assumes that this is an attempt to, well, to kill us, but also to draw our focus to Asriel. So he would like to try and track the woman.
Good idea.
So that was perception and survival, right?
Indeed.
And I'm in wolf form, so I have an easier time smelling her. So I will do that.
Didn't we agree that it was perception if it's smelling?
Yes, perception, that's what we said.
No, I mean the... Wait. Awareness and something.
Yeah, if I'm just smelling, but this is tracking.
He's trying to find out where she is and tracking through the place and following a lead. If you're just trying to catch someone's scent hanging in the air, it's
so
a,
I
yeah.
have.
But
nine,
if he's
eight,
just
seven,
following
six.
The scent,
that
then
is true because you can't actually see anything. So it would be
exactly.
Yeah, exactly. It's a good point. So it is perception and alertness.
Doesn't matter. I have the same score in athletics and survival. So, with a minus two difficulty, I have 998764.
That is pretty good. You get moving.
Yes, I track the scent.
Yes.
And
well, you catch other scents. That's the thing. You've never actually smelled Gina Masterson's. Well, that no, you hadn't because you weren't. Your previous character died at that lake, but Madi wasn't there, so he's never actually smelled her scent.
No, not unless I picked it up somewhere in the hospital.
Muted.
I shouldn't be muted.
You are.
He is.
But
the others are saying
I can
not.
Hear him.
I hear him just fine.
I think I had done something stupid here. There's a lot of sound problems today, ladies and gentlemen of the viewing audience. I am very sorry, but we are having severe technical difficulties.
Anyway, not unless I smelled her by the hospital.
No.
Or on the woman I tried to save.
But on an entirely different note, he doesn't smell of anything. Fenna doesn't smell of anything. Lou does, but he's been with him for a while.
Mm-hmm.
He can smell Mr. Idiot firing stuff at us.
Yep.
So the only smell he doesn't know...
There are several smells he doesn't know.
I assume, though, that...
It could be one of the recent ones.
There are
do they all smell like people, though? Because I assume people and things
several
smell different.
Several of them do.
Okay, well... I guess I'll just have to figure out which one smells the most like a female black spiral dancer or blood, and then go for that one. And that will be mostly based on a hunch.
Yes. So you try to follow... Well,
the freshest one is probably also a good idea.
Okay. And... Yes. Well, that means it is time for new roles.
I just typed 1d20.
Wow, we're getting worse, Taryn.
Well, I don't have to change anything except for the fact that I'm not spending rage.
Apparently being stuck behind a bar has motivated Taliesin to great initiative.
Apparently.
Use your round drinking, and then use a rage action drinking some more.
The bar has been defunct for 6 months. There will be no alcohol left in here.
Are you sure?
Well, I don't know. Did I hear the clinking of glasses when I landed behind the bar, storyteller?
Yes.
Oh, so there is alcohol. Probably worm-tainted by now, considering the location, but...
Your favorite deer is free.
Can I activate...
Should we sort the initiative first?
Yes, yeah, true.
Just before you start telling everyone what you want to do. So you should move yours above mine. Yes, move up in the world, Taliesin.
Move up in the world, you can do it.
Yeah.
Rage, you rage.
Can't hear you.
Lou starts by moving upwards. He is apparently he has a pretty good idea of where he's going, so he's moving up through the darkness.
Not that we can see it.
Nope. Fenna?
So, Fenna has this unerring sense of where Angel Guy is, and she has a gun.
That's a very good
point. Put two and two together.
That's a very good point. So she wants to shoot him.
Four.
Yes.
Hoping
that if she points the gun out of the toilet, then that there's actually no structures between him and her, because she doesn't know.
Excellent.
You know that gift you have, Fenna? Very useful.
Yep.
I was going to say, speaking of gifts, shall I wait until it's my turn before I act?
Yes, you shall.
Okay, just checking.
We are declaring in reverse order. That's how it works.
I know, just...
Taryn, what do you want to do?
She is continuing towards Mr. Throwing Ugly Stuff Around.
Yes.
With a sneering, I'm gonna get you, birdie boy.
And
in then, a low growl.
Yep. And then it is Asrael, who is, would you believe it, splitting his dice pool and actually taking offensive action while also keeping some dice to himself to dodge in case it should become necessary.
Hey, it took the round to get up. I should be up.
Ooh. You're up on the first landing, yeah.
Mm-hmm. But he's being smart. That's the smart thing to do.
Yeah. Did I?
Well, I keep tracking.
Yes. And Tali wanted to use a gift.
I did. I wanted to activate Unified Force this turn.
And seeing as it is you first, then go ahead.
Okay, so Taliesin focuses and activates his latest toy. Shall I give the players and the listeners the benefit of the gift?
I think it's a good idea, yes.
Would be a good idea.
A second, I just need to take away one gnosis point from my little pool. The player must spend one gnosis point for each turn this gift is active. Every turn that she does so, each player rolls initiative as usual, but the entire pack acts on the highest initiative rolled. The entire pack must be present in the battle for this gift to be active, and if even one pack member frenzies, the effect is lost. Only pack members bonded by a totem may enjoy these benefits. All pack tactics are at minus one difficulty while this gift is active. So basically, with this gift active, everyone can now act on Tally's initiative. In the pack, at least.
That is cool.
To attack the same target.
Yes.
Can't hear you, John.
Yes, again, I must apologize to the listeners here, but we are having serious, serious issues with the sound tonight. But I hope you're still getting something out of this, and I guess every group has their technical difficulties from time to time.
You should have seen the gremlins for me last night.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
It was horrible.
Okay. But anyway, I suspect it should now look like this, because Lou is not in the pack, so consequently he's not affected by it.
No. He's his own pooch.
Yes.
On a different note, if people want to see IS Gremlins from last night, I guess they can just go watch the other campaign.
Yes, they can go and watch our most recent, well, one of our most recent new campaigns here on CharismaToAC. There is a campaign called Masks, and I believe that is where aforementioned Gremlins happened. Anyway, well, it is then... Tali has used his gift, so Deadeye, you keep tracking and sniffing and so on, right?
Yep. I think. Can we hear him?
Oh, yeah, sorry, I just nodded because it's... Yeah. that's what I do.
Because we can hear you nodding, of course.
Well, no, the storyteller can see me nod.
Yeah, except if I'm looking into the screen.
That was basically it.
Mm-hmm. I was looking into the screen, so I didn't actually see you nod.
Oh, well, yes, I continue tracking.
Thank you. Go ahead and roll.
Find her.
Oh, I roll each round. Okay.
Yes, you do.
Well, you might actually get lucky and find
her. There are many, many, many scents in this place. And they are highly confusing.
But I'm smart, so it won't be a problem, I can assure you. He said before rolling a bunch.
Please don't, though. Don't jinx it.
Sort descending. 997211.
It's not a botch.
It's only one success, though.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, let's
That's
see.
Always fate.
Yeah, but I think I'll use something else, because we have a free reroll from Christmas.
Alright! Only that. For this!
So let's see if I get a better result this time. Slightly.
Yep. Okay. You have a good idea of where to go.
Yes!
And it takes you to a flight of stairs leading downstairs.
Mm-hmm.
That makes sense. If I can, it might be a good idea for me to... I not call out, because I'm in wolf form, but make... Oh, I can't make noise. Never mind.
You can make noise. You can just choose to. Can't you?
I will actually have to check the gift. I can muffle any sound I make. And
you
since I've activated...
Muffle. Yeah.
Yep.
I guess that means I can make a sound.
You can.
But actually making a sound would counteract the whole purpose of sneaking and being silent, so I won't.
Okay. Taryn, what do? You continue to go for the bird?
I go for Asriel.
That's another
the
climb.
The birdie bird.
That's another climb check and another willpower check for that reason.
Yeah, I'm going up further, but I can't see shit, so that should actually help me a little. I can't see how far down I am. Though this is probably here, he's going to be a bastard, realizing that she's afraid of heights and then removing the darkness.
Oh god.
Fuck.
Nope, you can't climb.
It's not a bot, so you can't climb. I could always use a willpower and then force myself to do it. Yeah, she's gonna do that.
Okay, so you continue climbing.
Mm-hmm. But this time not as sprightly or kulhun, as you say in Danish.
Yeah.
It's just like...
You are not as cocksure.
No.
On the verge of falling. I don't want to do this.
It's just... I'm already up high. Why is the bird not here? Fuck, I have to climb taller. Don't remove the darkness!
You can go ahead and roll some climb.
I don't like this. I'm pretty sure she won't say it out loud, because that would just give him ammunition.
True. You still need to roll for climbing.
I know. I'm finding my climbing stuff. Yes. I have a climbing kit right here, look!
Ooh,
yay!
Cool.
I have a climbing kit.
Yes, you continue to move upwards at a reasonable pace, and you get up to the rafters this round, and you can now jump from one rafter to the next until you get to underneath the steeple and start climbing up that thing. Isn't that lovely?
I think by this time, because she did have to spend a willpower, she's mumbling, "Don't look down, look down, don't look down, don't look down, don't mm-hmm. don't look down."
And then we have Fenna, who has a gun.
Yes,
shooting time with a shotgun.
So
Fenna's got a gun. To paraphrase an old Aerosmith song.
So that is just dexterity plus firearms, yes?
Yes.
Gosh, shoot the fucker. Yay!
What is
you
it
shoot
loaded?
After the fucker.
What is it loaded with?
I think I have 2 successes even with penalties for stuff possibly being in the way.
Yes. What is it loaded with?
Oh, I don't know, whatever I got from
So regular rounds then, not silver, that was what I wanted to be sure.
Yeah, we did. I don't even know where we put the silver.
That is 2 successes. He sees you, because as I said, he can see you, and he's got a split dice pool, but you can't, if I remember correctly, no, you can't...
You can't dodge it?
No, you can't dodge a firearm.
But
that makes sense.
It doesn't hurt as much.
No,
it's
exactly.
Just
it's
regular lead. But on the upside, Taryn still has the gun she took from the idiot with silver bullets.
What is the
Because she didn't bring that.
What is the damage code on the gun?
I don't know. I just know it's pistol.
It's a heavy pistol. That's a damage code, I believe, of 4.
4 or 5.
Could somebody please check that for me? I don't have the book open right now.
I'm looking. I think I actually wrote mine down. Combat. I can't find it because it's ficking up. That depends on what type of heavy gun I can see. Because there is one heavy gun that's a 4 and there's one heavy gun that's a 5.
Well then, let's call it a 5. It's a heavy pistol.
Yeah.
Let's call it a 5. So, okay, in that case, you had 2 successes. Okay. That means he needs to soak 7 dice.
Oh, they just do automatic that amount of damage.
Yeah. That's what makes a gun very, very dangerous, is that it has that fixed damage code, and then you need to soak it. But it's lethal damage, so... Let's see. Oh, that was... 1 die too many, so I'm going to take 1 of the successes off, being fair on you guys.
Very kind of you.
I love it when you're being fair on us.
Mm-hmm. Well, you hear a growl when the...
Yay, I can hear him now.
When it impacts and it's... You shouldn't have done that, little girl. He says, and the next thing... Fenna realizes, because you're in the doorway pointing up into the darkness, the next thing you realize is that you're being bowled over back into the bathroom.
Hey! I just got up there!
By this creature trying to, well, do some horrible, horrible things to you. He is, in fact, he is in Krenos. He does have these massive wings, and because of that, when he bursts through the door, he's large even for a Krenos, and when he bursts through the doorway into the bathroom, he literally takes the door off its, you know, the frame of the door is split. He just tears through the wall and comes into the bathroom, and you can see him in all his horrific nastiness. He is beyond hideous. He's got this deformed face. His Krenos form doesn't have any lips, so his teeth are laid bare. He's got green, little green glowy flames licking up from where his eyeballs should be. Yeah, he's got the wings, but they're folded right now down over his back. He's got his whole body is dripping with this oily tar-like slime. He doesn't seem to have a hair anywhere on him in this form. It's just he's wet with this slimy substance.
He's naked.
Well, most people in Krenos are. And
they have fur.
Well, yeah, true. And he doesn't
sound very pretty.
He isn't. He's an absolute monster, something out of a nightmare to look at. And he attacks the moment he comes in. Basically, what he does is he swipes at Fenna, and forces her into the room with the sheer force of his, well, size.
Can I use my rage action to dodge?
Yes, you can.
I'd like to do that.
That's a very...
I only have one exclamation to all this. Fenna, I just got up here! And she's down at the ledge height.
Right, trying to dodge?
It's been a while. It's strength... No, sorry, dex plus athletics, right?
Yes, dex plus athletics.
One success? Two successes. Yes.
The difficulty is 6 on the dodge roll.
Yeah.
Unless there's a modifier for whatever reason, and I can't actually think of a situation that would. Well, that means you remove 2 of his successes, which means he's got less extra damage.
Yeah, that's good.
That is always good, obviously. The less dice he's got to roll to eviscerate you with, the better.
Uh-huh. At least now I can follow the extreme noise of shit being pulled to pieces.
Yes. And I think we can confidently say that you need to do soak. And you are in, I believe, was it Glabro?
Glabro.
Yep. That's still better. I think you have 2 more points of stamina, isn't that it?
I do. Good. And I have nothing else to add to my soaks, so...
Ow. Let it be a good one.
That's not bad. That's decent.
3? What's that?
That's good.
Is it difficulty 6 for this too?
Yes. Yes, it is. That is good.
Okay,
that
means, 3.
That means you take 3 points of aggravated damage from his claws.
Sorry, that surprised even me. Oh!
So, yeah. And he's got his 2 rage actions left, obviously. So we're getting to those. We're getting
it wouldn't happen to be possible to yell out of turn, would it?
Yes, you can.
In that case, Fenna yells upstairs bathroom.
Ow, 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 upstairs bathroom, ow, ow, ow.
Pretty much.
Yeah, it might be more like shrieking. Yes. Upstairs bathroom.
And then Lou has his turn. And none of you, obviously, downstairs can actually see what the hell he's doing. But he rolls his... Yep, he does. 2, 4. Ooh, very nice.
Why do I keep
oh my god, that is a roll for the ages, guys. Holy shit. Oh my god.
Guys, why do I keep forgetting to pick up that gift that lets me ignore penalties for being damaged?
Yeah,
ignore because you keep forgetting.
Mm-hmm. Well, guys, I can tell you that Lou has 8 dice to roll on what I just rolled. I rolled 7 successes and a 1.
Yay! So, good boy!
So, what happens is that Fenna sees the strangest thing happen. She's just been ripped into. She's obviously in pain because 3 health levels of aggravated damage hurts like an absolute bitch, if you'll pardon the pun. And suddenly, this gigantic slimy creature staggers forward as he gets hit from behind by what looks like a flying dragon kick.
Yay!
Yay!
From a Garou in Krenos.
Yay!
Does Asriel in fact go through the wall?
He does stumble forward, at least. Let's see how much damage this thing does to him.
If any of the rest of us were as competent as this.
Well, that is an obscenely lucky roll. And then we have to do some soaking. Very nice.
Do you?
Okay. He does, in fact, take a slight amount of damage. I will take note of that myself here. And no, he doesn't go through the wall, but he doesn't... I mean, clearly he has no idea that he's going to be attacked like this.
No.
He's completely, well, blindsided, if, again, you'll pardon the pun. And he stumbles forwards, this massive paw of his grabs out to get a hold of something, and he tears one of the hot air dryers off the wall on one side, and on the opposite side he pulls off down one of the stalls, and the snarl he emits is epic, to say the least. And Fenna sees Lou in Krenos, which is a very sleek form, and he is standing there in a classic Kung Fu fighting pose, and then he just reaches out his right hand towards the Black Spiral Dancer, turns his palm upwards, and does a come hither.
Oh dear.
I'm so tempted to go
channeling every martial arts movie ever made, but
yes.
Yeah.
No, just
he does, in fact, know Kailindo, as it's called, the Guru martial arts, so yes.
Excellent. Right. Guys, we need to get our shit together and be as good as this guy.
I only know how to
We
take
are the
it.
Fated Six, and we will honor you by accompanying us.
You upstaged us!
Oh, brilliant. Okay, well, okay. Then it is rage actions, and, well, he's got two of them. And
I'm just like, when this all is over, Terran will be clinging to a rafter somewhere.
And, yeah.
I just got up here, stupid bird.
Well, he's got two rage actions, and what he does is, because Fenna is already wounded and she is in Glabro, meaning that right now at least there is absolutely no question that the greater threat is Lou.
No.
So he tries to bull rush him back outside into the darkness, if for no other reason than because that will also obscure himself. But he tries to, and Lou of course has no dodge action on this, because he just did his heroic thing to get up here in the first place. So let's see.
Damn it, Lou, that's not how you are a crutch character.
He does get him, he hits him, and takes Lou through a part of the wall and one of the beams that connects the roof and the floor of the walkway outside. This is, so he smashes through the wall and through the beam and comes sailing through the darkness down onto the bar
catch Tally.
Well, Tally doesn't know that he's coming, so let's see. There is actually a chance that Tally is going to get impacted by this, but it's not big. Okay, you don't get hit, but Lou does take a very nasty fall.
At least it's not aggravated.
No, it's not. It'll be lethal damage.
Mm-hmm. So now, yeah, so... Excellent.
When we got to party in the church, we party hard.
All right. He does take some damage, and now we try to soak. And yeah, he lands badly and does take damage. So, and there we go. Yeah, there we go. Okay. And that's the first of his actions, rage actions. The second one is another. He follows up in an attempt to attack because he sees where Lou lands. So he sees that down there he's got Lou, and he's got Tally. And Lou is temporarily indisposed and trying to pick himself out of all the broken bottles he's now occupying. So, Tally, you get the honor.
No.
Mm-hmm.
And he tries to attack you. He does hit. Not very Life. Well. So, not many extra dice.
Okay, so what am I...
You are soaking, is what you're doing.
Okay. What did I roll last time?
That's, still stamina.
Yeah.
For some reason, Taryn doesn't know. She really hates the GM right now because she just got the fuck up there!
Well, she's got the high ground on him now.
Yeah, that is true. But she's also afraid of heights.
Time for all the best Star Wars references.
The being wounded, it's minus two, so I need to take two off of that, don't I?
No, not on soak rolls.
Not on soak. You still get your full stamina on
you
soak.
You get full soak. Full okay. Stamina for soak roll.
Oh, for shite's sake. Stop giving me ones!
You don't subtract ones on soaks.
No.
I don't care. It's still a...
Well, it's not a success, annoying. But it's three successes, so you take another two points of aggravated damage.
Which means
at least I can hear where he is now.
You better help me quickly, because I'm officially crippled.
Yep.
Don't worry. Flying Terran coming
is incoming, yes. And he doesn't seem to realize that she's up there.
That's good. Because she doesn't want to think how far she's dropping, so the darkness is actually helping her.
Yep, that's true. we need new initiatives here.
Row one.
And it's also
10 plus.
Yes, we shall.
Seven. Half tempt.
We will just do the rolls, and then we will do the. Then we will take the second break. So we will start the new round when we and declarations and so on when we return, right?
I understand Tally having that initiative right now.
And let's see about Lou. Lou has had absolutely abysmal rolls on his initiative so far. Really, he's rolled 1, 2, and 3 respectively.
In order?
No.
Go, Lou.
No, not in order. It just went down. Damn it.
There we go.
Fenna, move up.
Move up in the world, Fenna. You can do it.
So.
And there.
Did I have a different font?
Okay, and we shall do decorations when we come back. So, let's see.
I declare my undying love for pastry.
Yes. And... This is... Yeah, okay, well, guys, we will be right back with the final hour of this very tense session of A Song of Tara. And, yep, be right back.